with the loudness. There we go. How you doing, everybody?
All right.
Oh my God, look at all the cameras. Was there a school shooting here? What's going on? Plane go down? Is that what's, Dale? I'm just not used to this much attention with the camera. You know, I went to Denny's last night at like 2 o'clock in the morning. And if you really want to feel good about yourself, go to Denny's at 2 o'clock in the morning. Got like coming here, actually. Can we get Mom and your feedback? I love that sound. Amelia, how are you doing, sweetie? You doing all right? You're looking snazzy. If I wish my mom dressed like you, she'd be more popular. So, you guys having a good time tonight? Okay, now we've heard from the drums. Everybody else having a good time tonight with the band? A friend of mine has a boyfriend who hates flying. He was, he's probably in the bathroom now, isn't he? But he was at the bar shortly a while ago, telling me about how his boyfriend hates flying, and, you know, the whole, you know, everybody tells you about flying. You know, it's the safest form of transportation. You know, oh, it's the famous, they'll tell you that when you get on a plane, when you sit down and your knees are knocking together, the stewardess is coming up, you know, flying is the safest thing in the world. It's the safest you shouldn't be. They got people know what they're doing. They've been studied up on this, and they, oh yeah, but you know, right before the plane takes off, the stewardess is like, all right, everybody look, if this fucker goes down, look, doors here, here, seats float, I'm out of here. And now they have, get this, peanut-free flights. Peanut-free flights they have now. I'm not making this up. Has anybody heard about this? Some people on the plane are apparently sickened by the smell of peanuts, so they have peanut-free flights. I think maybe the smell they would be sickened by would be like, you know, the 9 kids that the woman brought on the plane with her that's stinking up the back.
I love the smell of any kind of nuts.
Any kind of nuts? Madam, see me after the show. No, really, Mops, no. No, it's a, I remember when you used to be able to smoke on a plane. All the days, they used to be, I'm so, it makes me so old now. I can remember that.
How old are you?
When you could smoke on a plane. What?
How old are you?
9 and a half. Anyway, I miss that. You know, now I'm not a big fan of being trapped on a big cylinder, shooting through the air at 35,000 feet, and it being smoky, but I think I would take that, the smoke, over, I don't know, the smell of the two really old people sitting right across from me. That kind of masked it. Oh my God, my high school principal's here, ladies and gentlemen, right there. Right. No, I'm kidding, he's my drug dealer. Anyway, stop a little bit. How many hate their jobs? Anybody out here? You, what do you do for a living? What? Suck, woman? It's a fun job. Anybody work in food service here? Food service. You like it, do you? You like food service? What kind of food do you service? You're cooking backstreet. Well, there you go. Hey, I said four burgers. I got the goddamn burgers out when it was in the back. The kitchen is on fire. Yeah, that's quality dining. Backstreet.
And no trash.
No. Anybody here? Retail? Anything? Anybody work retail?
I'm in the wholesale business.
Wholesale business? I don't even want to go there. Stop.
Guess you go retail when you get a new table.
Oh, God. Anyway, no, there are a lot of people here that I've talked to in the past, but there's people that love what they're doing. God bless you. If you love cooking and backstreet, God bless you. But if you're in a job or a relationship that you hate, if you look over at your spouse, laying there, or boyfriend, or, you know, somebody you met 5 minutes ago, you roll over and look at them in the bed, and your first thought is, I want to kill him. Then it's not good. It's not good. And all those shootings in the post office. How stressful can the post office be? How stressful is that? Well, they got one person peeking around the corner going, wait, there's only 20 people in line. No, we're fine. Pour me another cup of coffee. No, there's one law firm buyer. She goes, no, they look pissed, aren't they? I'm a federal employee. I don't give a shit. You know? How stressful is that? Because the guy gets stressed out at the post office, pulls a gun out, goes on a shooting spree. A shooting spree at the post office is like the guy standing there and the gun's like. Coffee. You know, they're not going to get around to it real quick. You know what I'm saying? You go to the post office, you're not going to get mowed down. You have a better chance of getting shot running into the gun. You know what I'm saying? I'm going to check on these people back here. How is it? Is everybody fine? Everybody's just nice. Good, your eyes look so pretty. All right. Before I turn it over to the people back here, I'm going to do this little thing called mic check.
This is the desk mic. I'm testing the desk mic, and I'm speaking at a volume where people would normally speak.
How's that? That was good. Now I'm going to check the other mic. There's a mic backstage. I understand there's a mic back here. Is there a mic to be? Okay, this is the backstage. Do I have to get on my knees for this like last time?
Okay, this is the backstage mic, and I'm Casey Kasem. Our next artist got to start when he was 14. His mother was a prostitute. His father got drunk one night and sheared off both legs with a family lawnmower. Now here he is singing, Daddy, Don't You Walk So Fast.
All right, there's that mic. All right, my name is JT. I'm going to hand over these lovely ladies. Right there.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's hear it for JT Barry. Oh, come on, are you alive out there?
No.
Let's hear it for JT!
No.
That's more like it. Now, do I remind you, we are taping for television. However, it is appropriate and also welcomed to tip the entertainers, including the comedian. She'll like to be tipped too, what the hell. All right, let's start this baby. Get a cocktail, sit back, relax. It's time for the Mouth of the South Live. Hit it, DJ Alopecia.
Award-winning gossip diva, Miss Evelyn Mann. Tonight, we're proud to bring you the comedy stylings of Alyssa Barnett. And from New York City, Miss Whitstock herself, the Lady Bunny. So sit back, have a cocktail, and relax as we put some sound in your mouth. Now give it up for your hostess, the one and only,
little bundle of fun. She is going to take you all the way there. And direct from New York City, honey, the one, the only. She is, well, if she didn't get harpooned out on the beach today in Savannah, she's going to be right here on the stage tonight. Direct from Wingstop, ladies and gentlemen, the Lady Bunny! And of course, we got the fabulous threesome of craziness here. Myself and the fabulous Emmy Award-winning Evelyn Mims to give us all the entertainment gossip. And of course, no show would be complete without my sick little sidekick that makes me complete. Well, she does her best. Ladies and gentlemen, let's welcome her to the stage now with a thunderous round of applause, Trina! Torment from Lollapalooza and Club Makeup in L.A. And the performances this week will be by Glampire from Squeezebox in New York.
There's an interview on the cover of
Etcetera magazine. You can read that. Joey Arias, who of course channels Billie Holiday. It's gonna be fabulous.
I didn't know Billie Holiday spent so much time in the men's stalls.
I didn't either. And there's a surprise, special surprise at Glitter Dome this week. Peg is gonna sing rock and roll. It's gonna be scary, honey. You better be there to witness this. It could be the only moment this ever happens. They could drag me off in a straitjacket afterwards. I don't know.
Either that, or you'll get a recording contract.
Right, honey.
It could go either way.
I've got these fabulous passes here. It gives you $5 off of your cover with an invitation if you want one. Come see me afterwards. And $1 of every ticket goes to the Rainbow House,
which
is a safe house for young gay and lesbian children. Runaways and want to get away, and I think it's a fabulous thing that we're doing.
And I'll be spinning, and no course, request. Yes.
DJ Tiny Tears will be spinning.
Write it on $1.
Write it on $20. What about this dollar thing?
Now, also, is it my understanding, where's Mr. Briggs?
Is Briggs in the house? I think Briggs is here somewhere.
I know it's not on the thing, but isn't Apple Love?
Also, Apple Love is supposed to be
Apple
coming
Love,
too. Yes, that's right.
Apple Love.
The return of Apple Love, all the way from Tampa, Florida. Oh,
so,
Lord.
Get your butts down there.
But you know, I thought I came across this on the internet this week, Trina, and I thought about you.
Is it naked pictures of me?
No, it's not naked pictures of me. Thank God I would have gone blind and I still wouldn't have been able to read this on the show. But a young woman had just purchased her dream car, a new BMW convertible. She was having trouble tuning her radio to the station, so she ran back to the dealership, confronted the salesman, complained about the radio, and he said, "Well, miss, this is a very sophisticated radio. There is no requirement to use buttons or dials. You merely just give voice commands for whatever type of program you desire." So after she got her instructions, she headed out on the highway and she said, "Country music." Instantly, Garth Brooks was singing away on a country station. Well, after a while, she got bored with that, so she said, "Oldies." Suddenly, out of the blue, here comes Fats Domino singing Blueberry Hill. Well, right about that time, this woman comes along and a new Cadillac cuts her off in traffic. And she screams out, "Stupid, inconsiderate bitch!" The radio paused for a second, then she heard, "Hello again, and welcome back to the program. This is Dr. Laura." Love that, evil bitch. We hate you, Dr. Laura, in case you didn't know, we're just telling you.
Oh, we've got more cameras.
So
what's this on?
Oh, we've got Out TV here visiting us tonight, filming our show. The new gay TV in town. And they're going to come up and talk to us later. We're going to have a big old time. And we may be appearing on their show.
Yay!
So you can see us in two places.
Woo.
Well, three places. You can also see us in the Metro. And four places for Trina. You can see her in the men's room later. Usually laying next to the urinal. Chewing on one of those lovely little tablets. It's not a breath mint, Trina.
It's better with a little large. I broke all the piece.
Look, a biscuit. Who gave me this? But these are some fabulous new things from George Carlin's class on philosophy. Things for you to think about, to go home and consider in your moments of leisure. So I want you to think about these. There are top 15 things to think about when it comes to philosophy. But first, if man evolved from monkeys and apes, why do we still have monkeys and apes? If someone with multiple personalities threatens to kill themselves, is it considered a hostage situation? Isn't it a bit unnerving that doctors call what they do practice? Would a fly without wings be called a walk? Why do they lock gas station bathrooms? Are they afraid someone will come along and clean them? This one is very important, and we'll have to ask Turtle about this later, but if a turtle doesn't have a shell, is he homeless or naked? One to think about. Why do they put Braille on the drive-thru bank machines? If you're here to dream in Atlanta, this is not a question in your mind. Is it true that cannibals don't eat clowns because they taste funny? This one's for you, Trina. To be intoxicated is to feel sophisticated, but not be able to say it.
Say it, don't spray it.
Never underestimate the power of stupid people in large groups. Give a man a fish and he will eat all day. Teach him how to fish and he will sit in a boat and drink beer all day. Before they had been in drawing boards, what did they go back to? If all the world is the stage, where is the audience sitting? And the last and most important, if work is so terrific, how come they have to pay you to do it? Those are things to think about in your time of leisure.
I think about those things all the time.
Ow. Now we have a call to action, kids. We do get serious moments on this show. It seems that the American Atheists have launched a campaign against Bill Clinton to resign as the honorary head of the Boy Scouts of America. In the wake of the recent U.S. Supreme Court decision permitting the Boy Scouts of America to ban gays and others from leadership positions, American Atheists have called upon President Clinton to resign his post as honorary chairman of the Boy Scouts of America. A letter sent to Mr. Clinton and by the AA President, Ellen Johnson, urged him to consider your status as honorary president of the Boy Scouts of America, as well as the special relationship between the federal government and the BSA. She also called for an end to federal subsidies and endorsements of the BSA. And just for your information, every president since William Howard Taft has served as the honorary head of the Boy Scouts of America. So if this is something that is important to you, as it is to me, you know, I think if they're exclusionary, they should not be subsidized by our government, who's getting money from all of us. So just go on to the atheist website, which is www.atheist.org/action. And you can go ahead and have your name placed on petitions. And that's our political moment for the day.
Thank you very much. Now let's party!
Now it's time to get drunk and stupid! Alright.
Let's start right here.
So did you have fun last night, girl? I heard you went to Backstreet afterwards with...
I had so much fun, except trying to get Bunny's wheelchair up those stairs.
Oh, honey, that's hell.
That's so hell. It was easy getting her down, though. I just pushed it.
Well, you should have taken the forklift that we got her up on the back deck here. And that would have worked out perfect. You know, I'm sorry that we don't have the thing they have in New York to get her to her club.
Who was here last night?
You know, it's that sling that they put whales in to put them back into the ocean. It works everywhere.
Who was here last night and saw the show?
No one.
Was anybody here?
No one.
Oh, bye.
Oh, okay.
See, she warmed them out so bad they're both sleeping. So, buddy, you can do the same show tonight. Don't worry, honey. It's okay.
Well, I'm just waiting for her to, when she falls down tonight, that way I'll know if it was scripted or not.
Yeah, well, if she falls down tonight, she might stick. You've been on stage, so, you know. Trina does tend to leave a trail out here, you know, so just be prepared.
Dollar bills!
Not dollar bills, girl. Vodka.
Change. That's fumes pay.
Oh.
A vapor trail.
Well, I think it's time for us to move on with this show. Are y'all ready for some show? Do you hear that? They're excited. They're ready to hear us shut up.
I don't think people can hear that on TV, even with these little microphones.
I know, we need little microphones out there for the audience, because we do have a big audience here for all of you out there on TV now.
So, one more time. Everybody try and be loud enough.
Be real loud so they can hear you out there on TV.
That's
great. And my deodorant's still working. I love it. How fabulous. All right, it's time now for us to bring out our first entertainer. Our first entertainer I've worked with for several years from working with comedians in Atlanta, being comedians in Atlanta. She is one funny, crazy girl, let me tell you. She taught me everything I ever needed to know about lesbian life, like lesbian nirvana. Lesbian nirvana is a U-Haul with a stand-up shower. Remember that, just so you know. Ladies and gentlemen, without any further ado, I think it's time for us to welcome to the stage the comedy stylings of Alyssa Barnett!
Hello, Metro! Woo! Alright, y'all in a good mood? You having fun?
Oh, I know.
Are you having fun?
Yeah!
I'm in a great mood today. Great mood. I'm glad to be here. Actually, I'm in a good mood because I was getting ready to leave my house tonight. Guinness Book of World Records called. Apparently, I'm the only perfectly round person on Earth.
Right.
Well, this is the truth. My measurements are 40, 40, 40. So, that's pretty good. Oh, yeah. I don't care which direction you go. 20, 75, they all go the same way. But it's kind of funny because, you know, you're jaded living inside the perimeter. You know, you live in Midtown, you live in Decatur, where a big bone girl lives. And, if you live there, you drive it down the street, you see a woman with her hair cut and that 7 on the side, driving a pickup truck. You just know, right? You pull up next to her, you just know. Apparently in Stockbridge, this is not true. I had no idea how many baby seats you could fit in the front of a truck. This is true. So did y'all have a good Pride? People. How come we don't have straight pride? We don't need heterosexual pride. I say they do have it. You know what it's called? NASCAR racing. Yeah. You don't see us go there. We don't go there. And then when they ask you about, how come we don't need to have a straight pride parade? Oh, they have that too. It's called 85 North on Friday night. That's it. I have a very stupid friend. She tried to meet a blind date at Pride this year. And the woman told her, I'll be the woman with the short hair and the HRC cap, the tank top and the denim shorts and the knee brace from the nasty tennis accident. Can you imagine the chaos? Every woman looks exactly the same. We all start to look alike after a while, and after you've been married to the same woman for a while, you actually start to say exactly the same on the phone. When you pick up the phone, nobody can tell you apart after a while. So, I got a new truck. Come on! That's a big thing in a lesbian's life. It's funny because my friend came over with her boyfriend, my straight friend. We keep them around for fun. And they came over and he's walking around my brand new truck, my sport utility vehicle. And he was a little jealous and he gets to the back. And what is the first thing as a queer person you do when you get a new truck or a new car? You have to go and put stickers on it. Like you can't, drive by and there goes a duck. No, I have to advertise. Stickers everywhere. So he gets to the back of the car where all the stickers are and he gets back there and he says, did that come on there? I went up to the car dealer, and they gave me the option of either the sport package or the big dyke package.
Hurry, Honda!
And I went with the big dyke package because I got a couple of good things, actually. I got $10 off my next pair of Birkenstocks. I got some Melissa Etheridge CDs. And a whole glove compartment full of dildos. Doesn't get any better than that.
You're my favorite mechanic.
So, let me tell you a little story about something that happened to me. This is kind of funny. Thought I'd share it with you. I was recently at the mall. And I don't really care for the mall, but that's where they put the Abercrombie and Fitch. So, I was trying to make my way through the mall, through the Macy's, to get to the Abercrombie and Fitch to get my outfit for the Christmas party, and this woman, she stops me, and she was so nice, she said, can we give you a free makeover? And I said, really, no thank you, I'm just trying to get, through here. And she was so sweet, she said, we would like to update your colors. And I said, I don't really have any colors. Is red and blotchy a color? And let me tell you what happened. She got three of her friends with the slick back hair and the white coat. They committed a hostile makeover. That's exactly what happened. It was terrible. So, what else are we gonna talk about? I'll tell you though, I am really glad that I am a lesbian though. Because I saw one of those penis things once. Y'all ever seen one of those? I'll bet you have. It moves on its own. penis. Up and down all day, up and down, like an amusement park ride. If that's what I wanted, $30, Six Flags, and I don't have to drag the rest of the ass around. But I'm going to tell you one thing. I have figured out the difference between gay men and lesbians. I have. That will someday be credited to me, so remember my name. It's the big and little thing. You know what that is? It's not what you think it is. Anything you think that's big, we can buy. If you change the name of the store, we still know where it is. No, it's the big and little thing. Now listen, this is the truth, I swear. You go into any gay man's house, right? They have the littlest couches and little tiny chairs with the settees, little tables, and then the biggest floral arrangement you've ever seen. And the biggest mural ever made on Earth. You go into a lesbian's house, complete opposite. The biggest couch with chairs that pop out the side, big tables, and then one little precious moment sitting up in the corner. That's my time, thank you very much.
Let's hear it for Alyssa Barnett, once again. Woo. We need to do a little promo real quick. We're going to shoot a little promo for the show. Let me know when you're ready.
I'm ready.
Okay. Are you ready? Okay. 5, 4, 3.
Hi, you're watching Peg Live, Mouth of the South on People TV. My name is Alyssa Barnett, your favorite short, fat comedian.
Woo! All right. You want to do another?
Hi, my name is Alyssa Barnett, and you are watching Peg Live, Mouth of the South on People TV.
Okay. And coming back, 5, 4. Welcome back to Mouth of the South Live. Let's hear for Alyssa Barnett. So great. You know, I got a chance to sort of work with you, but you didn't perform that night. Peg actually performed with you, and that was a few weeks ago, and that was the show.
Eddie's Attic
in Decatur, and it was a lineup of gay and lesbian comedians, and you did the first
show, and
it was called, it was a very clever title.
It was actually called Glam, Spam, and Dental
Glam.
I was the glam.
I was the spam. So how long have you been doing stand-up?
About 4 years now. About four years.
And I always ask, what made you get into it?
I have no idea. Someone said I was funny and just started doing it.
I usually cry when people say I'm funny.
not funny that way.
Oh, okay. Funny that way. So where did you start out? I mean, there's not like a lot of venues, especially in Atlanta, and I would imagine over the past few years where lesbian or gay comedians could.
Well, I think I've broken down a couple of walls. Let's say.
Oh, okay. Like Stockbridge
and Wilbur and other fine communities such as that.
You know, you can always find, you know, some common thread in those communities.
Well, it's hard, but. You know, you drive real fast.
And what was your first show? What was it? Was it like an open mic or?
Open, lots and lots of open mics, and anywhere they give you stage time. Anybody who puts you on, you gladly do it.
Now, what was the hardest hurdle to get over? I mean, are you always comfortable in front of people or?
Yeah, I guess.
I mean, getting up on stage, I know that it can be a bit taxing, yes.
You know, unfortunately, sometimes you do a show where people are not really there to hear comedy.
And it gets really
ugly, and they get real loud. But, you know, for the most part, people are very receptive. People like to laugh, and I think I've shocked quite a few people when a big dyke walks in, and...
They're not going to mess with you.
They're all afraid of me, and usually that's why they laugh, so it works out very nicely.
It's nervous laughter, but then they get into it.
They do. You know, it's amazing. I really think that I've been an ambassador to what I can and think I have them.
Let's hear it. We all because Gwinnett is great. And that's what the water tower says.
That's right. And in Snowville, where everybody is somebody, unless you're queer.
Oh, really?
Isn't that their slogan now?
I think so. I don't know how they fit it on around the license plate, but anyways. So, anything coming up for you, or?
I'm actually taking a little bit slow. Which is a comic term for I have no work. I actually do have a fundraiser coming up. I do try and donate some time every year to different causes. A fundraiser coming up for the Ormwood Park Presbyterian Church.
No, that's Matt Montgomery, who was on the show last week. He's going to be giving that as well.
Matt's going to do that.
And where is that going to be?
That is August the 5th at the Ormwood Park Presbyterian Church.
Presbyterian. That's a party.
They are much more open-minded than I had anticipated.
Well,
very, very nice people. And glad to do it. I have some friends who are very involved in the church there, and they're actually having a commitment ceremony there. So, I'm glad to be
there. It's going to be a fundraiser just for the church, or?
For the church. They have no air conditioning in their church hall, so we have to help them.
Well, especially you'll appreciate it after you have to perform in there with no air conditioning.
No kidding.
So, are you a member of the church or?
No. I'm a nice Jewish girl.
Oh.
I just raise money for them.
Peg's one of those three things.
I know. Peg looks a lot like my mother, so it scares the hell out of me.
Well, gotta listen.
She has the same hair as my mom, actually.
She does have the same hair.
It's Carol number 17.
What about the back hair? My mom's gonna get me when I go backstage.
You're exactly right, though. That everything about it is everything about it.
Wonderful. Well, we appreciate having you on the show, and we always hope you'll come back and join us, or you know, just come and hang out.
Anytime, y'all have been great.
And one last question I did have for you is, where do you get? I mean, everyday life, is that where you? I mean, new material. I mean, do you like? Say, all right, I'm tired of this material, I'm going to bring in some new material, or?
I'm always adding to it, you know.
And it's just you kind of weed out the older stuff?
I started with 5 minutes of material 4 years ago, and I probably have close to an hour now. We're going to keep adding, and
you're ready to put your HBO special.
Hopefully.
I think they should do it, but, you know.
I knocked that Ellen off of there, not yet.
There you go. Well, ladies and gentlemen, once again, let's hear it for Alyssa Barnett. Thank you very much, sweetie. We'll be right back with the Lady Bunny.
Coming back to you in 5, 4, 3. And now it's time for all the grease that's not fit to print. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome the Emmy Award-winning Emily Mims with Mims the Word.
Shit out. those questions for free. Now, you know what was the hottest movie this weekend? It was the X-Men. It made $57.5 million this weekend, so it kind of ran away with everything. So, and they said it's a really good movie, so I plan to go see it. And don't you just love Halle Berry with that blonde hair and those strikingly, I guess, kind of bluish, greenish, peculiar looking eyes? Well, she's hot. I love her. Brooke Shields got engaged. Yes. Her and her tennis honey will not be living back together. She's engaged to another guy now. Planet Hollywood logged on too. Bruce Willis talked Shaquille O'Neal into begging Planet Hollywood, pulling them out of debt. And they now have a website that you can go on once again and pay your money and find out what the stars and all the athletes are doing. Sad news. I, who grew up in Mississippi, had nothing to do but watch TV when I was growing up. And one of my favorite shows, which was one of the only shows that came on, was Petticoat Junction. And Meredith McRae passed away this weekend. Sad but true. We're gonna miss her. Now, everybody loves, I think everybody loves Project Open Hand, at least I do. You go into Oscar Thompson's shoes up at Perimeter Mall and buy one pair, ladies, listen, and buy one pair of shoes, but they're on sale. They will not only take off $10, but they will also donate that $10 to Project Open Hand. So we love Oscar Thompson's, and all their shoes are priced between $29.95 to $69.95, regularly almost $300 to $400 pairs of shoes. Okay. Now, guess who was in town this week? Magic Johnson. Yes, he flew in on Monday morning, went to South DeKalb Mall, and he kind of, you know, had an anniversary party for Starbucks there that he opened up and he owns part of. Then he went over to Cascade Road, and he christened the Starbucks on Cascade across from the Home Depot. So not only can you go over there and get your tools, but you could also have a cup of coffee. You know, do two things at once. You know, this is like what Peg and Mikey did to me tonight. They put me in between the lesbian and the big old drag queen. So they killed two birds with one stone. Anyway, we love her. Now, Mumbo Jumbo is having their big anniversary party with their new staff this weekend on Friday night. So if you want to go and have fun and eat and drink and be merry, go over there and, you know, have fun. And then go to Glitter Dome and see Trina and Peg. That's what you do this Friday night. Now, for all you people who have nothing else to do with your lives but watch TV like myself, Survivor and Big Brother are doing very, very well. Now, you know that with Big Brother, you can kick the person off the show. And so it looks like Will and Jordan are up to be kicked off. Now, personally, we have a black man and a white woman. So therefore, I think the brother is out the door. That's what I think. But who knows? Now, all the Emmy nominations will be announced this coming Friday morning. So let's everybody, you know, think positive, burn a candle, and hope that Will and Grace will get nominated for several Emmys, right? Yay, Will and Grace. Now, a little bit of soap talk. Arlene on All My Children found Stuart, but she's decided to keep him in because, you know, she just thinks she'll have more leverage that way. Dimitri wants to stay here because he doesn't want Edmund and Alexandra to know he's there so they can be happy going with their lives. On Guiding Light, Cassie and Richard finally got married with the help of Reba. Now, you gotta remember, when Reba had her amnesia, she was married to Richard, and they had a kid together. So, after she remembered who she was, she forgot about Richard, came back to America, and, you know, she got back together with Josh. So then her sister met Richard, and they got together. So now she's the princess, he's the king, they're married, and Reba's just a good sister. On Passions, Ivy confessed to Sam that Ethan was conceived on her wedding night. And you gotta understand, she wasn't married to Sam on her wedding night. She was married to another man, but she conceived Sam's baby. On Days of Our Lives, Chloe and Philip got closer after she avoided the chicken blood falling on her head, you know, because Philip got all of that. And Isabella is going to come back. Isabella, who is married to John, she's going to come back this week from heaven and be a ghost and save Eric from something. Now, everybody remembers the infamous Cobalt and Super Bowl Sunday and all that madness that happened up there. Guess what? It's been sold for only $37,000. And the owners of Cobalt have bought center stage. So they're just going to bring all that madness to Midtown. I say stay up there in Buckhead myself. That's what I say. You don't need to come down here. Right? Right. We all love Cher. Y'all know Cher is now 54 years old. Yes, she looks fabulous, don't you think?
Oh, yeah.
But now she thinks she's missing something in life. So she has decided she wants to adopt a baby. At 54 years old. I don't know about that one, Cher. I can't, you know, I just don't see her birthing no babies at this point in her life, but if that's what she wants to do, I say go for it. I don't see Cher doing that, but if that's what she wants to do, she's got a life, you know. She's got the money to buy a baby or two, so just like Rosie, so buy the babies and be done with it. Now, ABC is getting ready to launch this very interesting campaign to promote the show Norm moving to Friday, but it's going to be geared toward men. Yes, geared toward men. And they're going to have slogans that say, and I swear they said this, oh my God, look at the size of that thing. And they're going to, and the other thing is, hey, watch your shoes. Now, they're going to put these little advertisements in urinals in New York and Los Angeles. I say some people will just do anything for ratings, don't you think? And that's what they're doing. It's just a big old mess. Jimmy Garth,
You got it?
Squat. I'm okay.
Beat Scots will never hear it, never see it.
You know.
Now you have to listen close with this because it's going directly into their camera.
Okay.
That'll be the day. You know that.
Keep my mind. We can do
she
that.
She loves it.
All right.
We're getting
she
the
loves you. She loves you. I love you.
Okay.
Okay.
Now we won't have to worry about this.
Yeah,
this. I can do the same thing with her. She'll talk, I'll hand it to her, and she can hand hers to me. That'll be
and
great.
You're so well, like, loud put them together.
Well, I'm loud anyway, Queen. Why are you squatting? We can't see you. Stand up, Ralph.
I've got my dick in my pocket.
Oh, you can squat now, honey. We can see you. I'm just playing. You want to sit on the edge of that? You can sit right there on the edge of that.
I can do this.
Well, don't put your crotch on it. I don't want my drink to be spoiled.
You can drink both of us.
Oh. Okay, here we go.
All right. Hello, my name is Leanne Reed. I'm with Out TV Atlanta.
And me, I'm Ralph Bailey with Out TV Atlanta.
Peg, it's so great to see you again.
Well, it's great to have both of you here. I'm very excited about it. And I'm really excited about a new gay series going on in Atlanta on Media One.
And it's really kind of slick. It's really kind of looking good. And we're really kind of building a little reputation here in town. And it's a great thing for all of us, Peg. I know that we've been working here for a long time. We've been shooting it out. It's been like going nowhere. But now we got a little bit of a reputation, you know. Now
we all have the reputation.
Maybe for once we can mean something.
Right.
Yes.
Yes.
I love your show. This is the first time that I have seen it. I've read your article a bunch of times in clips, but how did you start all of this? How did it begin?
Well, and actually, this was a brainchild of mine for many, many years. It actually started about 7 years ago. The first person that I shared the idea of doing a television show with was our technical director and DJ here at the Metro, Alopecia.
Alopecia!
Yes.
Alopecia!
And it's just like he said,
you know. I could say a little bit about alopecia!
Well, I know you could.
I just wanted to say that.
You know, Ralph,
I just wanted to say that.
I love you being obnoxious. You're just about the most obnoxious person I know.
Well, I'm forward. I'm only forward.
And I love that about you. It's fabulous.
Well, it's okay.
Well, you know, honey, they call me obnoxious too, so it's okay. I like it.
It's you now. It's you now.
See, that is me now. There you go. Let me talk. Shut up. Anyway, this was an idea that I had about 7 years ago, and I shared it with Al. And like Al said to me, you know, ideas come to everyone, and it's time for you to do something and execute the idea. So I waited for the timing to be right, and we worked hard, and I got together a group of really hardworking people, and we have a fabulous staff of people that are working for no money, where none of us are making any money off of this. It's about giving back to the community, and I tried to use my experience with writing a column for 10 years in this city, and my experience on the stage in theater, as well as a drag entertainer, and try to take all of those things and meld it together with the expertise of fabulous talents, like my fabulous cameramen, Jody and Polly, my backstage help, my associate producer, Mikey, and Amelia, who are without flaw, Alopecia, who is the most fabulous and finest technical director you could ever ask for. And then working alongside of that, we have...
Take that, Chicago.
Working alongside that, we have two fabulous people that work with me on stage every week. Trina Saxon, who is
Trina.
A dynamic talent.
Hey,
Bruce. There
she is.
Look at her. Pay me now, girl.
That's
get
a dollar
just
I gave
me a cocktail,
That's
bitch.
A dollar I gave him.
I knew it was. Her. And then, of course, we couldn't forget our only Emmy Award-winning winner on this stage, Evelyn Mims, who is already familiar with television and working with television, and it's really... It really is great having her expertise here with us and her wonderful talent. And she's so loving and so giving.
Evelyn.
And we really do have a family of people that work together and make this happen every week. And without them and without the help of the fabulous Metro and Kaya, who are sponsors for us, it couldn't happen. And we couldn't be out there for you on television every week. But it's really wonderful. And I'm glad to see somebody else joining the fold.
Oh, thank you very much.
Great. Thank you. We're novices. And I would like to think of us as just as total admirers, and as we humble ourselves at your feet, because you've done just a great job for the city as a whole.
Thank you.
And you've done a great thing for, and I think you're gonna begin to do a great thing on television.
Yeah.
You know, because we're gonna push you as much as we can here on Out TV Atlanta.
Well, I think it's got to be a cooperative effort. You know, we're here to help support you guys, give you any kind of tips that we can from the things that we've learned, and I know you're going to do the same for us, and we're going to be there to support you guys. And I want to say right now, the Mouth South Live loves Out TV, and we welcome you with open arms to Atlanta.
Oh, thank you much.
Thank you.
We love you,
thank
too.
You.
You're hilarious.
Thank you.
I love your show.
We're here with Peg, who's the supreme star of Atlanta, and...
That's right.
Leanne Reed?
Ralph
and
Bailey.
Me, I'm Ralph Bailey. We're here for Out TV Atlanta. Great. Good night.
Good night.
Thank you again. Let's hear it for Ralph and Leanne.
Leanne,
I'm sorry. I'm so stupid. I have no brain cells left.
Me neither.
I left in the 70s when I did all those clubs.
When do we need?
I quit doing it in the 70s too. Shut up. But anyway, I want to thank Ralph and Leanne for joining us tonight from Out TV. Let's hear it, crowd. All right. Thank you, guys. I appreciate it.
Thank you.
And now we're